Hey, what's up? This is Doug Joseph with Design 8 Studio. In my work to use my first LowRider 3 with a router on it to help make my second LowRider 3 for a plasma CNC cutting table, I thought I was all out of MDF to cut for the YZ plates. I was just about to use some plywood when I remembered that I had two perfectly circular MDF scraps left over from a previous project. And so I lined them up carefully and measured the distance between them so that I could create a single set of cut files and cut both YZ plates from these two scraps without having to keep changing my bits over and over again. There were basically three batches of cuts to do, so three bit changes. The first batch was for the smallest holes for the linear rods. These holes are too small even for a 1/8 inch bit to cut. I actually hacked this by attaching a drill bit, a 3/32 drill bit, to my LowRider 3 router in order to drill these in the first batch of cuts. Then a bit change to a 1/8 inch bit to cut larger holes. And finally, the very largest holes and the profile cuts were done with a 1/4 inch bit. After processing the art in CorelDRAW and exporting a scalable vector graphics, I brought it into ESTLCam and set up my cuts. And a quick confession here, after going back and forth and some minor decision making, I eventually exported my G-code file from ESTLCam with a mistake that later came back to bite me. I started off with hold tabs on those profile cuts that make the larger holes in the parts, but in later reworking things, I actually forgot to put those hold tabs back in. And so, as you can imagine, as I was making the cuts, there is the risk of a part that's not being held in place getting stuck in the works there, and that did come back to bite me. And so I later had to come back and revisit ESTLCam to make a modified rescue version of the G-code file to get back into cutting without losing the work that had already been done. Here you see me homing the LowRider 3 and then adjusting to get my point of origin. And now I'm showing you that 3/32 drill bit that I'm going to use to drill those 2.5 millimeter holes for the linear rods. I wound up wrapping some actual painter's tape around the base of the bit to get it large enough to have a good tight hold in the collet of the router. By this point, I'm ready to start drilling those 2.5 millimeter holes for the linear rods. And we're finally off and running on our first phase, which went off without a hitch. I've been watching things closely, but I'm really going to be watching this one closely. Recently on the V1 Engineering Forum, I was asked what my three top favorite improvements of the LowRider 3 over the LowRider 2 were. And one of them I named is the end stops. You could add end stops to a LowRider 2, but they didn't seem to be baked into the design. But I'm very thankful that Ryan of V1 Engineering did indeed bake end stops into the design of the LowRider 3. And this particular job would have been very difficult. In fact, the job would have been a failure if I hadn't had end stops. One of the neat things about end stops is that once you home your X and Y and then move to your origin point, if you take note of the X offset and Y offset between homed and your origin point, if you make note of that, then if you have a power loss or you have to do an emergency stop later, you can boot back up, home the device, and then you know exactly what offset to get back to the very same origin point. And this allows you to rescue jobs. So now you can understand why the end stops really helped me save this project. Because of that mistake I mentioned earlier, where I had to kill the power in an emergency stop because I forgot to include hold tabs, I had one of the pieces that wasn't being held in place to jump up and get caught up between the workpiece and the router, and I had to do an emergency stop, had to reboot the machine and restart the job, which locating the origin point was crucial. Matter of fact, let's slow it down so I can show it to you. So I had to emergency stop everything, and this YZ plate is going to be salvageable. There's a small cavity right on the edge here that won't affect functionality, and I'm fine with that. The reason why I'm showing you this is to illustrate the steps that I'm taking to issue a rescue or redo version of this profile cut. So I've deleted all of the parts that are already cut with the exception of one. I'll explain why in a moment. And I've deleted this circle because I'm a little bit concerned that this circle, that these screws aren't quite exactly where I planned them to be. I think this would maybe be a little bit close, and I'm concerned that if I try to cut this circle to make a hoop out of the circular scrap left over, I may wind up having my blade hit a screw. So I'm scrapping that idea. What happened with this long tall hole here is my table is almost flat but not quite. So as it was cutting this one, it didn't quite cut deep enough on the top edge of this one. And I'll show you a trick here in ESTLCam. When I have any of my other cuts selected, my toolpath depth is 19.5 millimeters with a start level of 0. But on this one that I'm redoing, it's already all cut except for just not quite deep enough right up here. So I've told it to go a toolpath depth of 0.5 millimeter, and its start level is 19. And what I'll do is when I set up my Z height, when I home my Z to the top of the material, I'll home it down slightly deeper than I did before. When I output the CNC file, you can see that there's only one cut pass that's going to happen on this one that's already almost all cut out.
and no cut passes at all on this hole, this hole, this hole, or this hole, or these two small holes that were already drilled. So let's head over to the LowRider 3 and take another shot at having the LowRider 3 cut parts for another LowRider 3. Again, my second LowRider 3 is intended to be used with a CNC plasma cutting table. Okay, so that's about it for the YZ plates, except for a little bit of cleanup, sanding, and painting. Please click like and subscribe. This is Doug Joseph with Design 8 Studio, wishing you happy making.